It's Lord Wisdom.
Super Tank.
With you.
yourself. Protect me. Your guard up! We'll be right back. myself. Keep your guard up! To protect me.
Will attempt to recharge these crystals. If you kill them before the cast goes off, great. If not, you'll have to deal with a few extra mobs that will spawn from each crystal. Tanks, be ready to pick up everything, go nuts with that AoE damage, and hope that your healer didn't forget to repair her gear before the run. Finally, we reach the final boss, Rukshazdeem. The aptly named Bonebreaker will target the primary target with a heavy-hitting Tankbuster. Cooldown and heal as necessary. Periodically, the boss will jump somewhere on the platform and cast Seabed Ceremony, which will deal high group-wide damage and spawn columns of water around the platform. This first variation has the middle of the platform covered by water. The boss will then cast Depth Grip, which will spawn a number of watery hands in sequence. Two players will also be targeted with large circle falling water AoEs that they'll need to move away from others. Eventually, the water hands will slam down on the platform, dealing high damage and debuffing players with vulnerability up. This seems like a lot of stuff happening at once, but if you look at the hands closely, you'll notice that they're not all facing in the same direction. Since players will find themselves on one side of the platform, they just need to ensure they're not in the way of a hand that's facing towards their side. This will give them the room necessary to avoid the attacks and debuffs. The boss will also cast Rising Tide near the end of this sequence, a large cross-shaped AoE. Avoid as necessary. Periodically, you'll notice the grates around the room start bubbling with water. Eventually, these grates will spawn adds. To block too many adds from spawning, players can stand on these grates. When an add spawns, the boss will form a meat shield around her, rendering her invulnerable. Players will need to destroy any adds before resuming their attack on the boss. Make sure you're handling the other AoE attacks while you do this. The next Seabed Ceremony and Depth Grip will have hands spawning on either side of the platform. Each lane of hands will have a gap that players can use to avoid damage and debuffs. If you're facing Bubbling Greats and Depth Grip hands at the same time, players will only be able to safely block adds from greats that are not in front of hands. Luckily, the hands will also destroy the adds, so you won't have to deal with too many at a time. Flying Fonts will mark a player for stack up damage. Move in together to share the damage. Command Current will throw out large AoE cones around the boss. There are four safe spots formed in between, and players will need to move into these to avoid excess damage. All of these mechanics will repeat until the boss is down. If you have any questions or comments,